Now, all these things happened unto them for examples. They are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world have come. Woe is me, for I am as when they have gathered the summer fruits, as the great gleanings of the vintage. There's no cluster to eat. My soul desired the first ripe fruit. Woe is me, there is nothing to eat. He's describing the effect of a famine of the word of God that has been prophesied by the prophets. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord God, I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor thirst for water, but of hearing the words of the Lord, and they shall wander from sea to sea and from north even to the east. They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord and shall not find it. There's a famine in the land. The majority in the secular church today is so full of Sodom's apples. And folks, I grieve over the multitudes throughout the United States and around the world. They're going to stand on the judgment day. And when they stand before Jesus at the judgment, they're not prepared, and it's all going to go up in smoke, and they're going to stand on ashes because they have not received life. They've not received the word of God that produces Christian character. There's no mention of sin, and so they've allowed sin to possess them. And what an awful day that's going to be. And listen to God's indictment against the ministers who have been afraid to deal with sin in their pulpits, afraid to feed the people with the life that sets them free. They say unto them that despise me, the Lord has said, you shall have peace. And they say unto everyone that walks after the imagination of their own heart, no evil shall come upon you. But if they had really stood in my counsel, and if they had caused my people to hear my words, then they should have been turning them away from their evil ways and from the evil of their doings. Isn't my word like a hammer and my word like a fire? There is no hammer. There is no fire in many churches left today. Nothing but straw. The good man is perished out of the earth. There is none upright among men. They all lie in wait for blood. They hunt every man his brother with the net. He said the good man is perished. Folks, it's alarming. It is absolutely shocking to understand that all over this nation, around the world, the best of them is as a briar. The most upright is sharper than a thorn hedge. The day of the watchman and the visitation cometh. Now shall be their perplexity. Doesn't that sound like it's today? It is today. This is the time of the watchman, and it's going to happen. The real focus of watchmen is not to scare people with what is coming, but to prepare people that in these times so dark and so depraved, that is when the word of God becomes so precious. And it's when you get a hold of that precious word of God that you rise up and become strong and powerful when others are weak and their hearts failing them for fear of those things that are coming upon the earth. And so now the prophet turns away from the backslidden church, away from the false prophets that are rising, and away from the greed and covetousness of a society that's gone mad. Let's talk about what God has in plan for his church, for this holy remnant that's seeking the face of God. Therefore, I will look unto the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me. He's talking about turning to prayer, waiting on the Lord, getting your eyes on Jesus. Turn your eyes toward the Lord. Turn away from all of these things. Wait on the Lord. Begin to seek his face. Begin to pray, and God will begin to answer you. Rejoice not against me, O mine enemy. Who's able to say to the devil, that's enough? Those who turn to the Lord, those who are seeking God, waiting on the Lord and on their knees praying, they're drawing close to the Lord, and God is going to empower them mightily to take authority over the powers of hell. He shall feed his flock like a shepherd. He shall gather the lambs with his arms and carry them in his bosom. God promises, first of all, there'll be no famine for those who turn to the Lord and seek his face. There are some people that would not be satisfied if their pastor was the Apostle Paul. There are people going around judging every church and every pastor and trying to measure their sermon tasting. Now, if you're sitting in front of a TV set and just lounging there, and you're complaining, I can't find a church. You're not on your knees. You're not in the secret closet. You're not into the Word of God. And you're wanting to find a church to solve all your problems and put some kind of a spiritual joy in you and pick you up and make you a saint. And it's not going to work. You're not going to find it. You're going to find it when you get on your knees and get into this book and seek the face of God. And God promises you. God promises you. You seek my face, I'm going to feed you. Miraculously, somehow, some way, you're going to get the word. According to the days of thy coming out of the land of Egypt, will I show unto him marvelous things. Thus saith the Lord, which maketh the way in the sea, and a path in the mighty waters, which brings forth the chariot and the horse, the army and the power. They shall all lie down together, and they shall not rise. They are extinct. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. I will make a way in your wilderness. I'm going to open the door supernaturally. As you seek my face and believe my word and my promise, I will open your sea. You will walk right through that besetting sin. You'll walk through all the opposition of the devil, because I'm giving you your own Red Sea experience.